Fanny and I have not had a proper marital relationship. She's an unrelenting nymphomaniac, and I'm a screaming homosexual. It seemed pointless trying to explain it to you, you little prigs. So we concocted this story to save your aunt from any further embarrassment. Anyhow, it's too late now. Toby and I are fleeing the country tonight in a fishing boat.
But what about the stolen bomb? And Dirty Dick? And the two famous scientists? And the poison meat?
That was all just a ruse to put you off the scent. They were all third-rate movie actors employed by me.
Well, you're wrong about one thing, Uncle Quentin. There is something we can still do, and that's call the police. Homosexuality is still against the law in this country, as well you know it.
Oh, dear. I thought even you, Julian, might find a morsel of sympathy for your poor old uncle. For old time's sake.
It's no good, Uncle Quentin. You're a queer, and that's the end of it.
Hurrah! Hit the police!
Well done, famous five.
We've had our eye on these two for quite some time now, and thanks to you, we've caught them red-handed. Well done, Timmy. It'll be a long time before they see the light of day again. It's youngsters like you we need in this country. I'm proud to have met you. Best of luck, famous five.
Well, that was an adventure and a half.
Yes. Who would have thought that of Uncle Quentin?
I'm glad he's been safely locked up. I never liked him one bit anyway.
Well, I think after all that excitement, we deserve a slap-up meal, don't you?
Yes.
Rather, I'm starving.
What a superb idea.
Cold ham, turkey, heaps of tomatoes, bags of lettuce,
yes,
hard-boiled eggs, and lashings of ginger beer.
Hurrah!